Thank you.
Because you have your new album out, Fabulous.
And isn't it?
Yes, it actually is. Thank you very much for asking. Now, where'd you get the name Fabulous from?
Well, you know, you can't make an album of disco music without kind of not taking yourself too serious. So when we're in the studio, it'd be, oh, Miss Easton, you're so fabulous. Like, oh, what a fabulous vocal. So we decided to call the album Fabulous.
Well, that actually makes sense because I must admit, reading through some of the songs that that you perform on the album, you've got Don't Leave Me This Way, Giving Up, Giving In. That's obviously the big single at the moment. Right. Love Is In Control, That's What Friends Are For, Never Gonna Say Goodbye. If you don't mind me saying so, a lot of gay songs.
And how would you know?
Because I'm hosting the Mardi Gras this weekend and I have to know these things for research. No, I'm actually, but they're right, but they're like the disco tracks, you know. And,
oh, fabulous!
And do you find is it an album that we're hoping that the gay community get into and boogie down to?
It's basically the first kind of commercial album I've done in a while, and you know, being disco, it's played in the clubs a lot. That's where it's embraced, and there's a lot of gay nightclubs. And being a female singer, I've always had a large gay following. I've always received your letters and loved them. And so, you know, this appeals to kind of like my core audience that have stayed with me since the 80s.
So do you enjoy disco? Like, do you still go out and party
Absolutely
when you can?
Absolutely not.
No?
No, I have two small kids, a five-year-old and a six-year-old. And, you know, I work for a living. I perform at night. The last thing I want to do is put on the high heels and go out discoing. I bounce around the living room with my kids, you know, to Britney.
Do you like Britney?
Oh, yeah. She's so great.
Really?
Yeah.
What is it?
She's got like that little tight booty that I used to have when I was, you know, 18.
I'm sure your booty is still quite tight. I'm sure that it is a butt that just won't quit. That's an ironclad. I reckon you can quote me on that.
Okay.
Now, you are still performing at the moment, as you were saying, and recently you were in Vegas performing with David Cassidy.
Yes.
Now, at any point were you a big fan of his, like in the Partridge Family days? It was a big spunk at the time.
I was a huge fan of David's right up until last year when I performed with them.
I have to get closer because this is what we're all about here. No, gives the juice.
No, really, when I was about 15, I used to go to sleep every night with his poster. It was David Cassidy, Donny Osmond, and Michael Jackson, like right in the days when he was singing love songs to rats, you know.
Oh, yes.
And the two of us need look no more.
Got it.
Yeah. So, yeah, I was into him then. Totally.
And so now, having performed with him, has it spoiled everything for you? Has it shattered your illusion?
Oh, like rancid meat.
Like haggis. Why? What has happened? What has David done?
No, no. See, you give me the straight line, I can't help coming with the punchline. No, it's, when you kind of idolize somebody at 15, that's one thing, but when you're working with somebody as a colleague in the business, you know, you see their feet of clay. Like, he sees my bad qualities and good qualities. So he's just a guy working for a living. And that's all I'm going to say unless I have my lawyer present.
Fair enough. Fair enough. Well, you've worked with quite a few spunks in your time. And even Roger Moore, James Bond himself, has said that you were better looking than any Bond woman he has ever seen. That's quite an impressive statement.
He was drinking a lot at the time.
No. You're cutting yourself short. That's wrong. Because now, you've also worked on Miami Vice, where you got to have a bit of a pash with Don Johnson,
Great
Mr.
Kisser.
No Socks.
No, what does that mean?
No socks. He didn't wear socks in at all.
Really?
He very rarely wore socks.
He always wore them in bed.
Fantastic. There's another little story that you're not allowed to tell us?
That's a big story.
Now, what was it like? Because you got to kiss him quite a bit.
To play his wife, you know, so we had some passionate 80s love scenes. And yeah, he was a good kisser, I gotta tell you. He was real good. Yeah.
What made him a good kisser? Because he had a bit of stubble. He was that stubbly kind of guy. And
well, it was more like the kind of, you know, the looks he had. He had those eyes like you do that.
Oh, not without your lawyer present. Melissa. Part of a ding ding. Now, one of the best known duets you've probably done was with Prince.
Mm-hmm.
Now, what was it like working with him? Because he's one of those strange guys you very rarely find out much about. How well do you know Prince?
Well, in the 80s, in the like mid to late 80s, we worked together quite a bit. And I think that maybe it was because the first time he called me up and he sent me a song to do, and I went over and just kind of like, you know, shook his hand and went to work. And I was maybe a little too naive to be in awe of him. So I just kind of treated him normal. And he's got a great sense of humor, which a lot of people don't know.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Really does, and we got along great, and just was one of those things that the whole world thought we were having this mad affair. In fact, the stories in the tabloids are fabulous. The video that you're seeing is we shot this in Paris, and the tabloids in Britain actually said that he bought me an apartment in Paris.
Wow.
And it then became a mansion. And as our love affair progressed, and of course they had to have it break up because that's more exciting, we dumped each other. I actually dumped him through ESP. That was a headline in the papers in Britain.
Let him down gently, you know, do it telepathically.
That's it. So how are you going to do, you know?
Well, as you are obviously well known from singing a duet with Prince, and would you do one with Britney at some point if you're such a big fan of hers?
Oh, yeah, I would. Absolutely.
Oh, that's good to know. Would you do one with
me? Her mom would have to remind her who I am, though, but yeah.
Now, would you do one with me? Would you just to play us off to the break, would you sing one last time, just to nip it in the bud, put it, a bullet in the back of its head, Morning Train?
You start.
Okay.
Pick it up and I'll join in.
We could do this at Mardi Gras, because you're going to be at Mardi Gras.
Am I?
Yeah.
Did you hear that?
I don't know.
Is maybe. That a rumor?
I don't know. Is your
Did
lawyer here?
There?
Is your lawyer
I
here?
I didn't
hear anything.
Here?
What, Don Johnson? He can't kiss. What are you talking about? Hey, ESP. ESP. I have no idea what we just said. Okay, well, I'll start us off and play us out to the...
2, 3, 4!
My baby takes the morning train. Ladies and gentlemen, Shannon Easton! He takes another home again to find me waiting for him.